format of writing a notice. First of all, outline. Draw an outline on the page. Okay? Draw an outline on the page. Without outline, the notice will not be considered to be correct. So outline the page, right? Then inside the outline, on the very top, you can write the word notice. Or the word notice can come even after the name of the institute. That is your wish. No hard and fast rule about it. So the word notice can be written on the very top, or it can come after the name of the institute, right? Then afterwards, the word notice will be followed by name of the institute, organization, office, or place, right? So after the name of the institute, to the left side, you will write the date. And the way the date is to be written is like this only. So write, for example, 10, today is 10th of June, 10 June 2021. Okay, don't write it like 10/7/2021. So write it, full month should be written. Then afterwards, the heading should be there. Heading for the notice should be there. A suitable heading. So the sequence is, number one, the word notice, then the name of the institute, date, then heading of the notice. Okay, heading of the notice is actually the main event of the notice. So the purpose of your writing notice might be like you want to invite the students for a meeting, then the title will be regarding the meeting, meeting of the house captain, something like this. Suppose the purpose of your writing notice is to inform students about some competition, then mention the name of that competition, solo dance competition or inter-class declamation contest. So suppose you are going to write the notice to invite names for office bearers. So nominations invited for the selection of whatever. So the point is, like, whatever the purpose of your writing notice is, that will be your title. And the title is to be very brief, hardly in about 2 or 3 words. Is that clear? So write a brief notice, and the notice should be written in capital letters, in bold letters, and it should be double underlined. The heading of the notice should be double underlined, should be capital, and should be written in bold letters. Okay, from a distance, the heading should be visible. So in a way, the heading is, you can say, the catching line. It is from here the audience or the readers come to know, like, what this whole notice is about, right? So after the heading of the notice, you leave 1 or 2 sentences, lines. Then you will start the body or the content of the notice. So when you write the content of the notice, the most important thing, the first of all, you must mention target group. You can note down the points. So content, when you write the content, the very first thing would be content, target group. What's the meaning of target group? Like, for whom are you writing this notice? Who should be the target of your notice? Like, do you want the, if the heading was like a meeting of office bearers, right? Then who do you want to attend the meeting? Of course, the office bearers. Then the target group will be the office bearers. The office bearers are informed, right? This is your target group. The office bearers are informed. There is always one mistake done by students. They write the first sentence like this. All the students are hereby informed. The word hereby informed, hereby has become a little obsolete. Obsolete means a little out of fashion. So it is an archaic way of writing a notice. It is like as if you are announcing something like in a royal manner. Okay? Like in earlier times when kings used to enter and the attendants used to call out like the king or your majesty is entering the hall, please all, so something like this. So the point is, like, it's not about that that spirit, you know. We are to simply inform, like, the office bearers are informed. No one will be using this expression like the office bearers are hereby informed. Okay, so that expression is not expected now. So simply, the office bearers are informed. So first of all, when you write the content, the target group should be there in the very first and second words. No need to say the school is going to organize a meeting and all the office bearers must come. That is not required. So start your notice. The content of your notice should start with the target group. Remember this, right? Along with the target group, mention what's the purpose of your writing notice. So the office bearers are informed that there will be a meeting, that they will have to attend a meeting with the principal as per the following schedule. So what's the purpose of writing notice? To inform them about a meeting, and meeting is with the principal, and when will the meeting be? That schedule we are going to write in a mini table. So overall, there is an outline, the main box is there, then this given, then this date, time, venue. Okay, that information can be written in a mini box or in a sub box. One outline, that was your main box. Now the date, time, venue, agenda, topic, so whatever those things, you know, you can write them in a mini box. So target group, all the office bearers are informed that they'll be attending a meeting with the principal as per the following schedule. So then make a mini box in the center and write on date, time, venue, theme or agenda, or agenda of the meeting, something like this, right? So then mini box will be about the schedule. After the schedule you mentioned, what else you'll be talking about, like reporting time also you'll be mentioning. If the meeting is at 9:10, 9 o'clock, reporting time at the mini meeting can be 8:50, right? Something like this. So mention date, time, venue and all important details and any extra information that is needed. So what's the content of the notice should have? The content of the notice should have target group, other information in the form of date, time, venue, agenda, theme, number of participants required, or the topic or the duration of the topic, right? Time limit or deadline. Okay, so deadline means like till when can you give the names? What's the last date for giving names? What's the last date for applying? Right, these things you must keep in mind. Like when you write a notice, then you must mention number one, target group, the other important details like date, time, venue, theme, agenda, topic, duration of the topic, deadline, that is the last date to give names or last date to apply, etc. Okay, last but not the least, most important thing to be written in the end of a notice is for further information, you may contact the undersigned. Okay, for further information, for any other information, feel free to contact the undersigned. Okay, then after this, you can put your signature, then your name, and then your designation. Is that clear? That is how the notice of format of the notice is. So signature, name, and designation. Is that clear? So here is one notice written. So see, on the top, the name of the school is there. Then the word notice is there. Then date is written. So what is missing here? Nothing is missing, but they have written the title in the to the left side. Title of the notice, change in school timings. It should be in the center. Central alignment you must use for the heading of the notice. Change in school timings, that is the title of your notice. All students are hereby informed. So here also the writer is using the obsolete form of writing the notice. So hereby word you are to delete from your vocabulary from today onwards. So all students are informed about a change in school timings from 1st October. Okay, so all students are informed that school timings have changed from 1st October. The school will now start at 9 a.m. and end at 3 p.m. In the past few days, it has been seen that winters are rather severe and it has become quite difficult to start early due to the extreme cold weather and the dense fog. So these new timings will be followed till further notice. For further information, contact the undersigned, name, signature, then the designation that is principal. So whatever you get to have from these sites, that is not always 100% correct. These things are there for you people to have some idea, but follow your teacher's instructions side by side, note them down. Okay, in the exams, you people get your marks deducted, not because you know don't know something, but because you don't follow your teacher's instructions. The instructions given by teachers in the classroom, they are the ones which give you 100 on 100. Okay, when you follow the other sources for information, they help you become fluent, they give you many ideas, they give you information on so many topics, they give you exposure. But in the end, 100 on 100 comes with your teacher's accurate instructions. Is that clear? So class teaching is very, very important. Class learning is very, very important. So that is all about the notice. So let us see one more notice of a little different kind. Yeah. So here is another notice. Lalwani Public School, Udaipur notice. So school is celebrating its annual sports day. On this date, students are informed to give their names for participation in various events to be held on sports day. The list of events. So here is a list of the events. So please give your names to the undersigned latest by 10th of November during the zero period in the sports room. So then your name, then signature, name and designation. So this is all about the notice. Now let's see something else. Uh,